mowed the grass every other day.
They had the capability.
Yeah, and everything's going.
He said, don't sit anywhere but over there.
As long as I'm not on the clipboard though, I'd be in trouble with that.
More pain, everything's clean.
But everybody called me Ellie.
Hey Bruce.
Hi, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good. Can you sit there, yeah?
Okay, tell her hi. Steve said that he'd tell you you're right here.
Thank you.
so creepy cool to me.
Hey, well, I want to welcome everybody to this Sunday afternoon, Bob's Barn Jamborees. I'm glad you're here, not out mowing your grass. You're going to see Johnny Hunt out of Midland today. He'll be here for about an hour. Matter of fact, he's here already. Anyway, out of courtesy to Johnny Hunt, we ask that you turn your cell phones off. Cameras don't like it. Also, please, no chit-chat, out of courtesy to Johnny, so the audience, we're recording this right now. And anyway, over here, there's a donation can that helps Lynn and I fix the floor and the roof. We gotta do something with the roof. We've had a terrible leak. Anyway,
If you need to use the restroom, ask your neighbor. Ask your neighbor. Once you all put your hands together, give Johnny Hunt a good round of applause.
Oh, I appreciate that. Thanks, Bob and Linda. I appreciate what you do here and making your facility open for aspiring musicians just to come and sing a few songs and have a good time. And I'm going to add one rule, too. I know we have a potluck, and there's no chicken wire here, so there's no throwing things at the performer, too, all right? So put that on your list for next time in case that's an issue. But I've been here, I think it was last fall, and I had a good time, and I'm going to try something different today. I've always had a music stand, something to look down at, but I have a little cheat sheet, so I call it singing naked. We're going to see how that goes today, do a little experimentation. So I like funny, happy, upbeat tempo songs, so that's mostly what we'll do. We got to mix it up a little bit. I like to start with an old classic, Carolina in the Morning. Nothing could be finer than to be in Carolina in the morning. Nothing could be sweeter than my sweetie when I greet her in the morning. Where the morning glories twine around the door, whispering pretty stories I long to hear once more. Strolling with my girlie where the dew is pearly early in the morning. Butterflies all flutter up and kiss each little buttercup at dawning. If I had Aladdin's lamp for only a day, I'd make a wish and here's what I'd say. Nothing could be finer than to be in Carolina in the morning. Flutter up and kiss each little buttercup at dawning. If I had Aladdin's lamp for only a day, I'd make a wish and here's what I'd say. Nothing could be finer than to be in Carolina in the morning. In Carolina early in the morning. You're too kind. I appreciate that. Thanks. All right. This is actually a barbershop quartet song, but so I revised it to a ukulele monotet song, not a monotone song, but just kind of a tongue-in-cheek fun song called My Old Man. My old man's a sailor. Hey, what do you think about that? He wears a sailor's collar, and he wears a sailor's hat. He wears a sailor's raincoat, and he wears a sailor's shoes. Every Saturday evening, he reads the sailor's news. And someday, if I can, I'm gonna be a sailor, the same as my old man. My old man's an anthropologist, what do you think about that? He wears an anthropologist's collar and an anthropologist's hat. He wears an anthropologist's raincoat and an anthropologist's shoes. Every Saturday evening, he reads the anthropologist's news. And someday, if I can, I'm gonna be an anthropologist, the same as my old man. My old man's a refrigerator repairman, what do you think about that? He wears a refrigerator repairman's collar and a refrigerator repairman's hat. He wears a refrigerator repairman's raincoat and a refrigerator repairman's shoes. Every Saturday evening, he reads the refrigerator repairman's news. And someday, if I can, I'm gonna be a refrigerator repairman, the same as my old man. My old man's a cotton-picking, finger-licking chicken plucker. What do you think about that? He wears a cotton-picking, finger-licking chicken plucker's raincoat and a cotton-picking, finger-licking chicken plucker's hat. He wears a cotton-picking, finger-licking chicken plucker's raincoat and a cotton-picking, finger-licking chicken plucker's shoes. Every Saturday evening, he reads a cotton-picking, finger-licking chicken plucker's news. And someday, if I can, I'm gonna be a cotton-picking, finger-licking chicken plucker, the same as my old man, the same as my old man. I'll fix my tongue here. You either get your tang all tangled up on that song. Well, my wife's feeling a little puny. She was intending to come along today from Midland, but so she's home, maybe watching on the live stream. But this is a church song, sort of, kind of. And instead of offending just a few people, it's meant to offend everyone. So this is called A Matter of Policy. Oh, a funny thing happened on my way to church last Sunday. Billows of smoke came rolling out the door. I rushed out to tell the leading deacon, get everybody out, cause the church is on fire for sure. He said, well, that's a point well taken, and a timely connection I'll sure do at the very next meeting. 3 weeks from Tuesday, it's just our church policy here at the First Nazareth, the Baptocostal, Seventh-day Orthodox, Lutheritarian, non-denominational Church of Our Lady of the Mind. Well, when I got to church the very next Sunday, there was a tent set up, paid for by the building fund. I stood up to tell the congregation, there's a tornado coming, everybody run. The choir sang, that's a point well taken, and a timely suggestion, we'll be sure to take it up at the very next meeting of the Board of Deacons, 2 weeks from Tuesday. I don't know why, it's just a church policy here at the First Nazareth, the Baptocostal, Seventh-day Orthodox, Lutheritarian, non-denominational Church of Our Lady of the Mind. Well, we had an open-air meeting the very next Sunday. When the trumpets sound and the clouds all rolled away, I stood up to tell the congregation, lift your head up high, for the Lord has come today. They said, well, that's a timely suggestion and a good suggestion, we'll be sure to take it up at the very next meeting of the Board of Deacons, a week from Tuesday. I don't know why, it's just a church policy here at the First Nazareth, the Baptocostal, Seventh-day Orthodox, Lutheritarian, non-denominational Church of Our Lady of the Mind. That's the policy. Thank you. All right. I thought it'd be a good time to not have to remember any words. So I think I'd like to play an instrumental now. This is it's an old song, goes back to the swing era, back in the 40s, and maybe you'll recognize Stardust. Thank you. on that one for a while. Thanks. All right. Phil Spector was a guy in the 60s. He put together all these girl groups and recorded a lot of songs. He's known for the Wallace sound. I mean, you can't do a Wallace sound with just a uke, but this is one of his songs that I like to sing. It's "To Know You Is to Love You." To know you is to love you. Just to see you smile makes my life worthwhile. To know you is to love you. And I do, yes I do, yes I do. I'll be good to you, I'll bring love to you. Everyone says there'll come a day when I'll walk alongside of you. To know you is to love you. And I do, yes I do, yes I do. Why can't you see blind can you be? Someday you will see that you were meant for me. Yes, I do, and I do, and I do. Hey, that's a lot of clapping for 18, 20 people, so appreciate that. Thanks.
You gotta do something loud.
Yeah, I remember that song. Thank you.
Yeah, you know, my grandparents taught me that song way back. No, that's not true. Yeah. I'm a liar. Don't, tongue in cheek. Who's up for a sing-along? You don't even have to know the words. Just a call and response. I'll sing a line and you sing a line. It's an old gospel song. I always liked Pete Seeger, and he did this at most of his concerts. And I don't know, it was an old gospel song. I'm sure he tweaked a few verses around, and it's called "That Lonesome Valley." So I sing a line and you just respond in kind. So here we go. You gotta walk, you gotta walk that lonesome valley, that lonesome valley. You gotta walk, you gotta walk it by yourself. Ain't nobody here can walk it for you. You gotta walk it by yourself. Daniel was a Bible hero, a Bible hero. He was a prophet, he was a prophet, brave and true. In a den of hungry lions, he showed what faith can do for you. You gotta walk that lonesome valley. You gotta walk it by yourself. Ain't nobody here can walk it for you.
You gotta walk it by yourself. Some folks say John was a Baptist. Some folks say he was a Jew. But the Holy Bible tells us that he was a preacher to a preacher to. You gotta walk that lonesome valley. You gotta walk it by yourself. Ain't nobody here can walk it for you. You gotta walk it by yourself. Though the road be rough and rocky, though the hills be steep and high, we can sing as we go marching, and we'll win that one big union by and by. You gotta walk that lonesome valley. You gotta walk it by yourself. Ain't nobody here can walk it for you. You gotta walk it by yourself.
Yeah. I applaud you. Got 97% participation, so that's pretty good. All right, here's a old blues song. You know, nobody, we can sing the blues, but I don't think we can really have the blues like, you know, the guys from the Mississippi Delta or the guys that came up to Chicago and try to find a job. But I'm going to sing one called the Empty Pockets Blues.
Oh, I never had a barrel of money. I never had a ruby red ring. All I ever had is you, dear, to sit and listen to me sing. I got the blues, the empty pockets blues. I never had a barrel of money. I never had a big Cadillac. All I ever had is you, dear, and that's a fact. I got the blues, the empty pockets blues. Money, 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 when will I make the grade? I'm so broke that a dollar bill looks big as a window shade. Never had a barrel of money. I never had a fancy suit. All I ever had is you, dear, and that's the truth. I got the blues, the empty pockets blues. Oh, I never had a barrel of money. I never had a ruby red ring. All I ever had is you, dear, to sit and listen to me sing. I got the blues, the empty pockets blues. I never had a barrel of money. I never had a big Cadillac. All I ever had is you, dear, and that's a fact. I got the blues, the empty pockets blues. Money, 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 when will I make the grade? I'm so broke that a dollar bill looks big as a window shade. Never had a barrel of money, never had a fancy suit. All I ever had is you, dear, and that's the truth. I've got the blues, the empty pockets blues. I got the blues, the empty pockets blues.
All right, here's another pseudo-biblical song. It's a children's song called Uncle Noah's Ark. Actually, it was Gene Autry sang it in one of his old cowboy films back in the 30s. So if you're a fan of old westerns, you might have heard this one before.
A long, long time ago, as most of you would know, Uncle Noah built himself an ark. For 40 days and nights, the weather was a fright. The animals nearly tore the ark apart. The ducks said quack, the cows went moo, the rooster cock-a-doodle-doo, the old tomcatcher raised an awful row, meow, the little pigs, the billy goat, bah, the bullfrog, biggest rain we ever had. Uncle Noah's Ark is a madhouse now. The horses and cattle and fowl of the air, even the long-eared donkey was there. Hee-haw! The ducks went quack, the cows went moo, the rooster cock-a-doodle-doo. All were there at Uncle Noah's Ark. At last the sun did shine through the winter long and fine, and Uncle Noah thought 'twas time to land. He couldn't open the door, left his hammer on the shore. The animals roared and growled to beat the band. The ducks went quack, the cows went moo, the rooster cock-a-doodle-doo. What's one of your favorite animals?
Or elephant.
The elephant went roar. Another animal.
That giraffe.
The giraffe went. That's all he did. I've never heard a giraffe make a sound. Have you heard a giraffe make a sound? One more. Another animal.
The camel.
The camel. You'd be surprised what kids come out like octopus. That's just. The ducks went quack, the cows went moo, the rooster cock-a-doodle-doo. All were there at Uncle Noah's Ark. All were there at Uncle Noah's Ark. And that's the story. I'm a baby boomer. I'm kind of in the middle of the baby boomer years. But, you know, back when I was a kid, there's one TV in the living room, you know, how that goes, and you had to get up and until the knob broke off, and you had to get a pair of pliers to change the station. But in Bay City, there's Channel 5, Channel 12, and Channel 57. And we all watch the same shows together. And you know, now we've got a TV in every bedroom, and, you know, kids got all these electronic things. But so we all watch the same shows, but so that means we also watch the same commercials. So what I did a few years ago is take a bunch of old TV commercial songs, kind of wove them into a song. And so you might recognize some of them, and you're welcome to sing along. This is the TV commercial medley. Hot dogs, Armor hot dogs. What kind of kids eat Armor hot dogs? Fat kids, skinny kids, kids who climb on rocks. Tough kids, sissy kids, even kids with chicken pox love hot dogs. Armor hot dogs, the dogs kids love to bite. Grab a bucket and mop, scrub it bottom and top. Tell me, what does it mean? At McDonald's it's clean. You deserve a break today,
So get up and get away to McDonald's. My baloney has a first name, it's O-S-C-A-R. My baloney has a second name, it's M-A-Y-E-R. I love to eat it every day, and if you ask me why, I'll say, 'cause Oscar Mayer has a way with B-O-L-O-G-N-A. Things go better with Coca-Cola, things go better with Coke. Life is much more fun when you're refreshed. Coke refreshes you best, it's the refreshing ests. Food goes better with fun, goes better with you, go better with Coke. The real live one puts extra fun in you and everything you do, 'cause things go better with Coca-Cola, things go better with Coke. Aye, 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 aye. I'm Chiquita Banana, and I'm here to say, bananas have to ripen in a certain way. And when they are flecked with brown and have a golden hue, bananas are the best and are the best for you. You can put them in a salad, you can put them in a pie, any way you want to eat them, it's impossible to beat them. 'Cause bananas like the climate of the very, very tropical equator. So you should never put bananas, no, 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 in the refrigerator. The minute you walked in the joint, I could tell you were a man of distinction, a real big spender, good looking, so refined. I figured that you were the Muriel cigar smoking kind. So let me get right to the point, you're right in style when you're in Muriel company. Hey, big spender, spend a little dime with me. Oh, I wish I were an Oscar Mayer wiener. That is what I truly like to be. For if I were an Oscar Mayer wiener, everyone would be in love with me. You worked too hard, you ate too much, this cheesecake made you greedy. If you're aching in the stomach, take this lesson from old Speedy. Alka-Seltzer, plop, plop, fizz, fizz. Oh, what a relief it is. Plop, plop, fizz, fizz. Oh, what a relief it is. And that's the TV commercial medley. I think I saw one of my friends from Mason peek their nose in the door. Hi, Laura. Hi, Deborah. All right. Well, I'm going to sing actually a serious song. You got to mix it up here. But I don't know. A few years ago, I started renting these old MGM musicals from the 50s. There's just a lot of good music and good stories there. So this is from kind of a more a little darker plot, but it's from Oklahoma. It's the leading song right at the beginning of the movie. Oh, what a beautiful morning. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. The corn is as high as an elephant's eye, and it looks like it's climbing right up to the sky. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got a wonderful feeling, everything's going my way. All the cattle are standing like statues. All the cattle are standing like statues. They don't turn their head as they see me walk by. And a little brown maverick is winking her eye. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Everything's going my way. All the sounds of the earth are like music. All the sounds of the earth are like music. The breeze is so busy, it don't miss a tree. And an old weeping willer is laughing at me. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got a wonderful feeling. Everything's going my way. Oh, what a beautiful day.
Right, over the Christmas holiday for school, I did a presentation for kids, teaching them a little bit about how to play the uke, and took some ukes I borrowed from my friends here. I bought them, actually. And, but I'm kind of between having kids elementary school age and having grandkids that aren't quite there yet. So, I was kind of thinking, well, what kind of songs do elementary school kids sing? What kind of music do they like? And because they sure don't know the old stuff that we grew up with, and I sure don't know what they're singing. So I said, well, maybe we'll find some common ground here in nursery rhymes. So I started, kind of recalling the nursery rhymes of my childhood and did a little research. And the more I looked into it, the weirder things got. Because some of these nursery rhymes are pretty bizarre. I found that a lot of them tie back to Bloody Mary. Back in England, back in whatever century that was. And that was just the common people's way of protesting the way they were being treated. But, think of some of the words like rock-a-bye baby in the treetops. Who puts a baby in the treetops? I think somebody should call Child Protective. Yeah. And, of course, then the wind starts blowing. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. So, you probably got 50-mile-an-hour winds here. Yeah. And then eventually when the bow breaks, the cradle falls, and down will come baby, cradle and all. So, that baby at the best has a fractured skull and maybe a concussion. So that was one that kind of hit me funny. And some of the other ones are, pop goes the weasel. Okay, remember that one. So picture yourself about maybe 150 years ago back in Ireland, because, it's St. Patrick's Day weekend, and the potato famine's going on, and they're having tough times making ends meet. And so the boys been down in the pub all day, and they're getting pretty soggy by then, and it's getting big about closing time, and they're running out of songs to sing. So they start making up all these songs. And one guy says, I got one for you here. Write this one down. All around the mulberry bush, the monkey chased the weasel. Oh, the monkey thought 'twas all in sport. Pop goes the weasel. Oh, they'll love it over in America. Look at these little things with the crank. and the kids will be crying. It'll be great. Trust me. Write this one down. So that was another stupid nursery rhyme. And then, I don't know, like, it's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring. He bumped his, how did he bump his head, and what did he bump his head on in bed? I don't know. Yeah, and then couldn't get up in the morning. So he got another concussion there. If he was a football player, he'd probably be, you know, sidelined for a few weeks there. So I did finally find one nursery rhyme that I thought I could do something with, and that was Old MacDonald. But even if you think about Old MacDonald, like Old MacDonald had one horse, he had one pig, he had one chicken, he had one cow. And that's not a success formula for having a successful farm. Because, you know, there'd be a day come when he decides, hey, I'd rather have a sirloin steak than, you know, a gallon of milk the next day. And what there goes the cow. Or I'd rather have a drumstick than an omelet the next morning. So there goes the chicken. So I started looking around on Old MacDonald there. And I found a couple variations that I thought were interesting. There's an Irish guy named Seamus Kennedy. And he put together a slightly different version. So I took some of the verses from him. And then there's another barbershop called quartet called Lunch Break. And they had another version of Old MacDonald. So I took a few verses from them. And the thing they had in common, and I don't mean to mock anybody or disabilities, so we just take it in fun. But this is Old MacDonald had a deformed farm. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm he had a lisping snake, E-I-E-I-O. With a hith hith here and a hith hith there, here a hiss, there a hiss, everywhere a hiss, hiss. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm he had a dyslexic sheep, E-I-E-I-O. With an ab, ab here and an ab, ab there, here an ab, there an ab, everywhere an ab, ab. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. I got it through my old man, and then I twisted up on this one, so I don't know. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm he had a narcoleptic pig. You know what narcolepsy is? That's where you, like, you fall asleep at the inopportune moments, like driving. E-I-E-I-O, with a here and a there, here a there a everywhere a. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had a drug-dealing duck, E-I-E-I-O. With a crack, crack here and a crack, crack there, here a crack, there a crack, everywhere a crack, crack. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had a grumbling horse, E-I-E-I-O. With a whiny, whiny here, and a whiny, whiny there. Here a whiny, there a whiny, everywhere a whiny, whiny. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had a bunion-infested centipede, E-I-E-I-O. With a ow, 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 here, and ow, 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 there, here, and ow, 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 there, ow, 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 everywhere, and ow, 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 ow. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O.
Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had a hyperactive sloth, E-I-E-I-O. With a... here. And a... there. Here a... there a... everywhere. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had an extremely nervous squirrel, E-I-E-I-O. With a ee-ee here and a ee-ee there. Here a ee, there a dog! Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had a lactose intolerant cow, E-I-E-I-O. With a... Old MacDonald had a deformed farm, E-I-E-I-O. Ah, I feel better now. It doesn't get much better than that, does it? I got a couple more here. I was singing in a group with a couple ladies, Leanne and Hillary, in Musica for about 12 years now. They never let me do this song, so guess what? I'm going to sing a song, it's a Thanksgiving song, called Al the Goose. Me and my goose, me and my pal, we had some very good times. Me and my goose, his name was Al, and he cost only a dime. Through meadows we'd stray, playing all day. I missed him at night until dawn. One day I found Al wasn't around. Where could a goose be all day? I searched everywhere, he just wasn't there. I wondered where Al might have gone. I missed my pal, I missed my Al. It's sad that things turned out this way. Then Mom brought him in, I remember her grin, stuffed with his feet pointed straight. I'll never forget the night that we ate Al off of the old yellow plate. Al the Goose, God rest his soul. All right, this is a newer song. It came out in 2000. You see, we have a hard time at our age connecting with teenage songs. But this is a teenage song I thought was kind of cute. And there's a group that tours the world called the Ukulele Orchestra of Great Britain. And they're all excellent musicians and singers, and they put on a great show. And they did this song, so I'm going to give it a spin here. This is called Teenage Dirtbag.
Mm-hmm.
Her name is Noel. I have a thing about her. She rings my bell. We got gym class in half an hour. Oh, how she rocks in Keds and tube socks. But she doesn't know that I'm there. And she doesn't care one bit about me. 'Cause I'm just a teenage dirtbag baby. I'm just a teenage dirtbag baby. Listen to Iron Maiden, baby, with me. Her boyfriend's a jock. He brings a gun to school. He'd simply knock me out if he knew the truth. He lives on my block. He drives an IROC. But he doesn't know that I'm there. And he doesn't care one bit about me. I'm just a teenage dirtbag baby. I'm just a teenage dirtbag baby. Listen to Iron Maiden, baby, with me. Yeah, 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 yeah. I feel like mold. It's prom night and I am lonely. Lo and behold, she's walking over toward me. This must be fake. My lips start to shake. 'Cause she doesn't know that I'm there. And she never cared one thing about me. I've got two tickets to Iron Maiden, baby. Come with me Friday, bring your ukulele. 'Cause I'm just a teenage dirtbag baby like you. Oh, 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 oh. Oh. Yeah.
A couple more here. I mentioned Pete Seeger. This is a folk song. It's kind of from the Depression era, when he was a big union supporter and. You know, it was tough to make a living in the Depression, and people were getting laid off and having a hard time making ends meet. So this is called The Banks of Marble.
I've traveled around this country from shore to shining shore. It really made me wonder the things I heard and saw. I saw the weary miner scrubbing coal dust from his back. I heard his children saying, "We got no coal to heat the shack." But the banks are made of marble, with a guard at every door. And the vaults are stuffed with silver that the miner sweated for. I saw the weary farmer plowing his sodden loam. I heard the auction hammer just a-knocking down his home. But the banks are made of marble, with a guard at every door. And the vaults are stuffed with silver that the farmer sweated for. I saw the seaman standing idly by the shore. I heard the captain saying, "We got no work for you no more." But the banks are made of marble, with a guard at every door. And the vaults are stuffed with silver that the seamen sweated for. I've seen my brother working throughout this mighty land, and I prayed we get together and together make a stand. And we'd own those banks of marble with a guard at every door, and we'd share those vaults of silver that we have sweated for. Well, I got one more. This is an old song from the 60s. So that's a good closer song. So good night, sweetheart. Good night, sweetheart, well, it's time to go. Good night, sweetheart, well, it's time to go. I hate to leave you, but I really must say, good night, sweetheart, good night. Good night, sweetheart, well, it's time to go. Good night, sweetheart, well, it's time to go. I hate to leave you, but I really must say, oh, good night, sweetheart, good night. Well, it's 3 o'clock in the morning. Baby, I just can't get it right. I hate to leave you, baby, don't mean maybe. You know I love you so. Good night, sweetheart, well, it's time to go. Good night, sweetheart, well, it's time to go. I hate to leave you, but I really must say, oh, good night, sweetheart, good night. Your mother and your father don't like it if I stay here too long. One kiss in the dark and I'll be going. You know I hate to go. Good night, sweetheart, well, it's time to go. Good night, sweetheart, well, it's time to go. I hate to leave you, but I really must say, good night, sweetheart, good night.
Good night. Thank you. Thanks to Bob and Linda for putting this on, and I've had a great time. I trust you've had one or two songs you enjoyed too.
You guys want an encore? Let's hear it. Maybe who's got another one.
All right, we'll just wing it here. You know, I'm a believer. That's, the older I get, the more I understand that it's all about getting ready for eternity. And I had the privilege of making a prayer sheet, and people that have these ongoing problems, whether it be health or financial or whatever, and try to pray every day for them. And I had a couple of ladies that passed away this week, so you know, they've moved on to glory. So this is a song about where they're headed, Sweet Beulah Land.
Mm-hmm. I'm kind of homesick for a country to which I've never been before. No sad goodbyes will there be spoken, for time won't matter anymore. Beulah Land, on thee I'm longing, And someday on thee I'll stand, where my home shall be eternal, Beulah land, sweet Beulah land. I'm gazing now across the river, where my steps shall end in flight. A few more days here to linger, and I will take my heavenly flight. Beulah land, for thee I'm longing, and someday on thee I'll stand, where my home shall be eternal. Beulah land, sweet Beulah land.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, wasn't that great? One thing before I get it, Wanda, raise your hand. Okay. Wanda, she needs you guys to pray for a successful surgery at noon Tuesday. At noon Tuesday for Wanda Lowell. Okay, next week we're going to have Michael Joseph Evans here from down around Homer. That's his picture there right beside Steve. He does all kinds of old-timey Civil War tunes. And you're not going to want to miss him. Let's see. We're going to unplug the cameras. Stick around for the jam. And you might get home by 11.